In the afternoon, alat, ha? Antayin muna natin yung kaklase mo. Give them 2 minutes before we start. Thank you. Okay, good afternoon. So we're done with our mid topic, which is the module 1, 2, and 3. So regarding your midterm exam, the result or the score of your midterm exam will be given by next week, because there are still some who haven't yet completed taking the midterm exam. So I'm still contacting them for the exam, and then by next week I'm going to give or enumerate or list the names na kulang yung mga quizzes, quiz 1, 2, and 3, and so midterm exam by next week. Pero sa regarding sa score po ninyo, ibibigay ko by, teka lang ha. So regarding po sa ano yan, regarding po naman sa mga yung scores talaga, so i-direct message ko yung ibigay sa inyo, kasi personal consumption nyo lang yung scores nyo for the quizzes and the midterm. So follow up ko lang yung mga ibang activities na hindi pa na-submit. Please submit na, kasi slowly ko siyang chine-check sa aking bakanting time. So especially for the coming December, so medyo mahaba-haba yung bakasyon, so I can use the time to check all of your outputs, okay? So today, I'm going to discuss the first topic for our final coverage. So your final exam will be on the last week of January. It was in the school calendar that your final exam will be the last week of January. So it means we still, the lecture, module 4, 5, 6, which is the coverage of your midterm exam, will be discussed for 3 months na lang. 2 months na lang pala. So we still have next week. Today is the last week of November. Next week is already December. December 1 na nga yung ating next meeting. So we still have December and then January. So last week of January is your final exam. And then our Christmas break is on the third week of December. So nasa dito is December 19 is our Christmas break. So ibig sabihin, since Thursday klase natin, so December 17 po ang ating last activity na ipopost ko. Tapos, we will meet by January 5. So January 5 na po tayo babalik for our Google Meetups, okay? So we have also 3 modules for this final exam. So final exam. So yung final exam coverage, hindi na kasama yung module 1 to 3. Ito na, yung bago, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so I'm going to start as to present my presentation for our module 4. So we're starting now with our classes for the first topic. Rita. Okay, so we're done. So we're now in the statistics. So module 4 is all about statistics. So tapos na tayo sa mathematics, how to speak mathematically, the sets, the functions, the patterns in natures, and also with the problem solving. So ngayon, deeper topics na po tayo. So the first part for the deeper topics is statistics. So anong meron, anong makikita natin sa statistics? Wait lang ah. So what can we found in statistics? So before we discuss statistics, we will first outline our units. So in statistics, there are 3 units. So first, we will discuss the measures of central tendency. So later on, i-discuss natin kung ano-ano yung mga measures in central tendency. Second one is correlation. So correlation, there are 2 types of correlation. We have the Pearson and the Spearman. So yung Pearson, i-discuss ko today kasama ang unit 1. Pero yung Spearman, isasama ko yan sa unit 3. Okay, which will be discussed by next week. And the last topic or last unit under module 3 is testing of hypothesis and regression. So these are the units or the topics that I'm going to discuss under module 4 of statistics. Okay, so we have the measures of central tendency and the Pearson muna ang i-discuss natin. So ibig sabihin anong makukuha natin ngayong output for this module. So this means that you're going to have 3 activities. So may 3 activities kayo because we have 3 units. So 3 activities. So 1 activity for unit 1 which will be posted on Thursday morning. 1 activity for unit 2 will be posted also by Thursday morning at Thursday afternoon. Or kung hindi magawa ko ng Google Form, baka isasama yung unit 2 sa next week kasama sa unit 3 na activities. And you also have, after discussing all of the units, of course, hindi mawawala yung isang quiz. Your quiz regarding statistics. So same pa rin, your quiz can be a praise or fill in the blanks, or it can be multiple choice. So ibig sabihin, at the end of your quiz, makikita niyo na po yung score ninyo. Minsan kasi hindi lumalabas yung score because of the server ata ng Quilgo or ano yung ginamit kong pang timer. Okay? So, don't worry. Ibibigay ko naman yung mga scores ng quizzes. Aside lang sa activities, kasi medyo marami-rami activities, so medyo hindi ko makuha yun. Kasi yung activities is an open-ended questions. Kasi kailangan nyo isosolve. Unlike sa quizzes and midterm, automatic, nandun na kagad yung answers, pwede nyo na kagad makita. Pwede nyo na din pwede nyo din kagad makita yung score nyo at the same time kasi nandun na kasi yung answer. While the activities, kailangan ko talagang manually i-check yon. Kaya medyo mahihirap, medyo matagal-tagal kasi ma-check. Okay? Just bear with me with this because may iba din akong ginagawa. Okay, so we'll now go with the unit 1. Our first topic for today, the measures of central tendency. Okay, so late as a Thursday, ibibigay ko itong link para basahin nyo or kita nyo sa YouTube yung about mode, median, mean, range, and standard deviation. So that you don't, you will also have other idea coming from other authors about the definitions and comparisons among these five terms. Okay, so definition of terms. So we will start first discussing or defining the statistics. So ano ba yung statistics? So in statistics, we have descriptive and inferential. So statistics, it involves the collection. So it involves the collection, organization, summarization, presentation, and interpretation. So yun po yung statistics. Bale, magko-collect kayo ng data, i-organize natin yung data, isa-summarize, ipresent po natin yung data in a tabular form. It can either be in bar graph, chart, or line graph. And then you're going to interpret this data. So that is the statistics. Ano naman difference ng descriptive nito and inferential? So ang descriptive is a branch of statistics that involves collection, organization, summarization, and presentation. So ibig sabihin hanggang dito lang siya, collection, organization, summarization, and presentation. Wala siyang pakialam to interpret what is the data all about. So ang descriptive niya, parang i-describe mo lang. I-describe mo lang ano yung purpose, ano yung data. Sample, ano yung kanyang, for example, if you're describing a human being, it's either boy or girl, o sasabihin natin, or male, female, sabihin natin, its height, his or her height, yung weight niya, or the complexion niya, yung kulay ng buhok, ganun. So, plain describing lang to tayo sa descriptive. While the inferential, it involves interpretations and drawing of conclusions. So, bale, sasabihin mo kung there is a direct or indirect relationship, meron bang siyang correlated, o mga ganon. So, ito yung kanyang interpretation dito. Interpretation po yung inferential. Unlike sa descriptive, you're just describing what's the data all about. So, those are the definitions that we need to define. Now we go to arithmetic mean. So ito na yun. Si mean or arithmetic mean is the yan, part of the measures of central tendency. So this is often helpful to find numerical values that locate, in some sense, the center of a set of data. This is now mostly the commonly used. Oh, ito daw commonly used measure of central tendency, ang arithmetic mean. So, arithmetic mean can also be called as mean. So, ano yung mean? A mean of n numbers is the sum of numbers divided by n. Yan po yun. So, ito yung kanyang formula. Yan. So, what is this? This is the summation. Ibig sabihin, you're going to get the sum of all the numbers in a given set. So, ito yung formula ng mean. You get the summation and then divide the n. N is the number of data you have. For example, okay, we have an example here. 6 friends in biology class of 20 students received test grades of 92, 84, 65, 76, 88, and 90. Find the mean of these test scores. So how will you find the mean of these test scores? First is you're going to add all of these test scores and divide the total number of data. Ano yun? This one, the 6 friends. Hindi itong 20. Tingnan nyo, i-count nyo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ibig sabihin, these are the test grades of the 6 friends, not the 20 students of a biology class. So we have, yan. So we add the test scores or test grades, and then we divide it into 6. Hence, we have 82.5. Wait lang, ha? So, 82.5. Therefore, ano itong 82.5? This is the mean of the test scores. That is the mean of the test scores. That is the mean of the test scores na kailangan natin. So that is how you're going to get the mean of the test scores. Wait lang ha. Sandali lang. May pumapasok kasi tawag. Wait lang. Okay, sorry for that. Okay, sana tayo. Okay, so this is the mean score. So, in getting the mean score, so you just need to add the value or the test grade. Then you divide kung ilang test grades or ilang tao ang kasali sa pagkuha niyan. So, that is the mean. That is how you're going to get the mean of the test score. Okay, next. So, in the mean, so before we go into sa mean, i-discuss muna natin yung dalawang term. Ito, these two terms are important. We have the population and the sample. So, ano yung population? Population is the entire group under consideration. So, in getting that mean of the population, you will use this one. Sandali lang ha. Okay, so in getting the mean of the population, so ang gagamitin natin, it's the same procedure lang, pero ang gagamitin natin is U. Pero in getting the mean of the of the sample, yun na yung kaninang ginamit natin, which is this one. Ito na yung mouse. Wait lang ha. This one. Kaya yung kanina, yung sa example natin, ayan. So yung sa example natin, ang ginamit natin ito. Why? Because we're just getting the sample, which is the six friends, the sample of the population of the biology class. Pero pag kinuha natin lahat ng biology students of biology class, which is 20, so ang gagamitin natin is this one, summation of x over n. So this is, ito na ang gagamitin natin. Pero the same lang po yung procedures. You just add all of the test grids, then divided by the total number of populations, which is 20. So, ganyan lang po yun. Okay. So, next. Wait lang ha. Median. So, sa median na tayo. So, ibibigay ko muna yung ibig sabihin. So, please read it silently in your place. May i-entertain ko muna tong text. Okay, wait lang.
Okay, so sorry for that, ha? So the median, so aside from the mean, meron din tayong median. So yung median is the middle number. So middle number ang kinukuha sa median pag add yung ating number. Add yung number of the data. Ito ay pag-add. Pag yung mean of the two middle numbers naman is for the even. Okay? So, the median is for you're going to get the middle number or the mean of the two middle numbers. But you must take note, in getting the median, you must rank it first, or rank list ang tawag doon, wherein you're going to arrange first. Wait lang ha, salad lang. Okay, so pasensya nga. Pasensya na talaga kasi may emergency lang. Okay, so we have here in the median. So sa median, aside from the mean, kasi yung mean, kailangan mong i-add all of the data and then i-divide mo kung ilang number of datas meron ka. While for the median, you need to arrange first from smallest to largest or from largest to smallest ang data pala. Why? Because you need to get the median or the middle. From the term alone, median, middle number ang kikunin mo. We can already
see the middle number pag add po yung ating data. While the even data, kailangan mong kunin yung two middle numbers. Ito na. Kailangan mong kunin. Kita. Hindi ko nakita ang kimos. Yes. Two middle numbers and then get the mean. Ano yung mean? You add the two middle numbers and then i-divide mo into two. Para makuha mo yung mean and that will be the median for that even data. Okay? So, yan po yung ating median. So, we will have an example for this. Okay, for example. So, sa example natin, yan, you're going to find the median, wait lang, you're going to find the median of the data in the following list. For letter A, we have 4, 8, 1, 14, 9, 21, and 12. And for letter B, we have 46, 23, 92, 89, 77, and 108. So, with this, anong gagawin natin? We're just going to find the middle number. But, hindi to pareha sa mean. You need to you need to arrange it first from smallest to highest or from highest to lowest. So, ang ginawa ko is I rank it from smallest to the biggest number. Okay. So, and then I'm going to count. For letter A, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, 7. So, add pong aking number data. So, nandito yung 9. So, 9 po ang middle number. So, this will be your middle number. Hence, this is your median. 9 is the median. For letter B, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 6, even po. So, we have 77 and 89, yung two middle numbers, kasi even siya eh. So, this is the two middle numbers. This is... So, I'm going to get the mean first. So, I'm going to add 77 plus 89, then divide it by 2, and I get 83. And 83 is the median. So, that is how you're going to get the median. So, magkaiba po sila ng mean. Ha? Ang mean, you're going to add all of them divided by the total number of samples. And yung median, arrange it to get the middle number. Okay. Now, we have the mode. Ano naman tong mode? So, the mode is the number that occurs most frequently in the list of numbers. Yan. So, meron tayong term na makikita. Merong no mode and more than one mode. So, ang no mode, ibig sabihin, walang number nag-occurs more than often than the other numbers. And more than one mode, pag meron tayong numbers na parehas ang pinaka-highest occurrence. So, we will... occurrence. So, we will have this with through an example. So, mas maintindihan natin ang mode with an example. Okay. So, we have an example here. So, we're going to find the mode of the data in the following list. So, we have 18, 51, 12, 18, 15, 21, 16, 15, 14, 15, and 21. And for letter B, we have numbers 2, 5, 8, 9, 11, 4, 7, and 23. Okay. So, what will be the mode for the letter A? So, remember ang mode, hindi na natin kailangang i-arrange from smallest to highest or from highest to lowest, just like for the mean. Ang median lang po talaga ang kailangan. Ngayon, ang mode is titingnan natin yung mga values, kung ilan yung merong mas malaking occurrence. So, meron tayong, okay, for 18, isa lang. For 15, ilan? 1, 2, 3. So, we have 15, 3 times siya nag-occur. And for 21, so ilalagay natin 3 dito. 21, we have 2. So, ang 16 is 1 and 14 is 1. So, ang pinaka-highest is the 15. Therefore, 15 occurs 3 times more often than the other numbers. Therefore, 15 is the mode. So, yung number 15 ang mode ng data na ito. And for letter B, 2, 5, 8, 9, 11, 14, 7, 23. Wala tayong makitang more than once ang occurrence niya. Hence, there is no mode. Ito na yung sasabi ko, wala siyang mode kasi wala siyang more than once na nag-occur. So, for example, nag-add ako ng data dito sa 20, dito sa letter A ng 21. Ngayon, 21 is already 3 times nag-occur, just like 15. Hence, ang answer natin will be 15 and 21 are the mode. Yan po ang mode. So, yan po yung mode niyan, 15 and 21. Therefore, ano mangyayari dyan? So, there are more than one na mode. Kaya yun na yung tinabi natin kanina, na there are sometimes to be no mode or more than one mode. So, meron tayong more than one mode. Pag ito na ang mangyari, nagdagdag ako ng 21, another 21, dito sa data na ito. So, 15 and 21 will be your mode. So, more than one mode na po ang ating modes. Okay, so this is for the mode. So, take note, the mean, median, and the mode are all averages. However, they are generally not equal. The mean is the most sensitive. So, among the three, mean is the most sensitive of the averages. So, that is why a change in any of the number changes the mean. For example, if nag-add ka ng pinakamalaki o pinakamaliit na numbers among those na na-compute natin ng mean, so, pag mangyari yun, so, mag-change din yung ating mean. Yun po yung ibig sabihin. While the median and the mode, actually, hindi siya mag-change ng extreme values kasi ang median, kukunin mo lang yung pinaka nasa gitna or yung mode naman, kunin mo lang yung pinaka highest na value na nag-occur. Ganon. So, that is the difference between mean, median, and mode. The mean is the most sensitive of the averages. Okay, so those are the mean, median, and mode. So now we're going to discuss the weighted mean. So what is the difference between the arithmetic or the mean with this weighted mean? Actually, parehas lang. Kaso lang, meron siyang ginagamit na weights in getting this mean. It is like mostly ginagamit ang weighted mean if you're going to get your average grade in first year or any year level you are in a certain subject. For example, so ito yung formula. Yan. So this one, yung sa numerator, is the sum of the products by multiplying each number by its assigned weight. At ito naman is the sum of all the weights. Yan. Okay, so we have an example. Example how you're going to get the weight. Actually, sa arithmetic mean yan, mostly ang gagawin natin is you're going to add lang this one and then divide it by 4 kasi ilang data yan. Apat. So, 4 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4 divided by 4, yun ang arithmetic mean. But take note, this is a course grade and a course unit. So, ibig sabihin, pag you're talking about getting the average or general point average, you're going to use the weighted mean. So, ano tong weighted mean? Okay, so, yung A daw is 4. Yung B daw is 3. Yung C daw is 2. And the D is 1. So, yan. I-change natin yung mga course grade or na letters from number. From letters to numbers. Okay, so, paano natin isosolve yan? Yan. So, ito sa tababa, hindi kailangan sa, i-count lang natin ilan. So, apat man yan. So, hindi yan ibig sabihin apat ang isosolve natin. I mean, i-divide. So, ang summation of W, it means that the unit, ito, yan ang i-add natin. Tapos, nakita natin that it is equivalent to 14. So, that will be your denominator. While for the numerator, anong gagawin? The grade, multiply it to the units. So, we have 3 times 4, 4 times 3, we have 1 times 3, and 2 times 4. So, after that, we have 12, 12, 3, and 8. So, yan po. And then, you add it. And then, we have a 2.5. So, that will be the general point average of DLONs in the fall semester. So, yun po. Ganyan po yung pagkuha. So, if you want to get your general point average for your first sem in your first year or second sem in your first year, ganun po ang pagkuha niyo. So, you multiply kung ilang nakuha mo sa English times kung ilang unit. Minsan, 3 units. So, 3 times. For example, nakuha mo is 1.5. So, 1.5 times 3. Tapos, 2.5 times 2 yung para sa chemistry. Mga ganyan. Hanggang 10, divide mo yun sa course units na meron ka sa isang semester. And then, dyan mamalalaman kung if you're qualified to be in an honor roll. So, kung 1.25 yung general average mo, so, ganun yung kinukuha nila ng mga deans and registrars in giving honors to a certain students. So, iko-compute nila ang kanilang general point average. So, ganun po ang pagkuha ng grade. Hindi yun automatic na i-add mo lang yung grade mo. For example, you have a grade in English 2.5, sa history 1.5. So, i-add mo lang 2.5 plus 1.5 plus ganun hanggang 7 subjects meron. So, i-divide mo into 7. So, himali po yon. So, kailangan mo i-multiply yung weight. Kaya nga tinawag to weighted mean. Okay? So, that's all for the unit 1. Ayan. So, any questions with the unit 1? So, I guess that's silence means yes. Or silence means no questions at all. Okay, so I guess there's no questions. So you have by Thursday in the afternoon, I'm going to post in your Google Classroom the evaluate activities, which will be the deadline will be on December 13th of 2020. So ito yung example na inyong questions. So ito yung sample. So in you're going to get the mean, the median, the mode. So, from numbers 1 to 6, meron kayong data, and then you get the mean. Anong gagamit? Sa Google Classroom, you don't need to show the solution. Bale, maybe lalagay lang ako ng blank doon, wherein sa blank, doon nyo po ilalagay yung answer. For example, sa number 2, ma'am, yung mean is 25. Na-solve mo. Okay, 25, ilalagay mo doon diretso. So, that will be a fill in the blank. So, I mean, kayo po mag-sustain, maglagay ng answer. For number 7 and 10 naman, So, ang gagawin nyo is to analyze the data. So, 7 and 10 is a multiple choice or two choices meron. Meron siyang 4 choices, meron siyang 2 choices. Pero yung kanyang, ang basis ng kanyang exercises is with this table. So, i-analyze niya yung table. Ma'am, baka tanungin natin, what is this frequency? Ito yung frequency, ilang beses siya nag-occur. For example, si 15, nag-occur lang siya ng once. 16, once lang. 17, 10 times siya nag-occur. 18, 7 times. 19, 13 times. So, ganun lang po yun. Ngayon, sa number 7, for example, select and, oh, so since it's a Google form, so select and tick which of the following statement is true. So, kaya na po, basahin nyo po and then you analyze. So, yung frequency ha, ito yung ilang beses yung score na nag-occur. Yun po yung frequency. Okay? Next. Okay, so we're done with the unit 1. So, hence, we will going to discuss the part of the correlation sa unit 2. So, ang unit 2, which is the correlation, so I'm going to discuss that because under the unit 2, meron siyang two types of correlation, the Pearson correlation and the Spearman correlation. So, yung Pearson muna ang discuss ko for today. Yung Spearman will be discussed with the unit 3 on next week. Okay. So, continue tayo sa correlation. So, what is this correlation? Correlation is the measures, correlation measures the association or the strength of the relationship between two variables X and Y. Okay? Okay, so we have, yan. For example, so hindi ko muna dadiscuss si person product moment correlation. So dito muna tayo sa example. So ano tong mga itong example bibigay ko is parang introduction sa correlations. Wherein sa correlation, didiscuss natin kung meron siyang positive or negative or zero correlations with the value. Okay, so we have here, for example, over this one. Suppose a 10-item test. A 10-item test in English and a 10-item test in mathematics were administered to 10 students. So, meron tayong 10 students. Yan. Itong, wait lang nga, yung mouse ko medyo, yan. Hindi ko makita. Okay, so these are the 10 students. So, for example, yung si student 1, nakuha niya is 4 over 10 sa math. Ito naman, nakuha din niya is 5 over 10 sa English. Yung student 2, 5 over 10 sa math and 4 over 10 sa English. And so on. Hanggang 10 students. So the scores of the students are tabulated. It must be determined if the scores in mathematics and the English test are correlated or not. Ibig sabihin, meron bang silang relasyon? Yung math test and English test. Ibig sabihin, pag mataas ka ba sa math, mataas ka din ba sa English? Or pag mababa ka sa math, mababa ka din sa English? Or the other way naman, mataas ka sa English, mababa ka sa math. Parang ganon. So we have here. Okay, in answering this, kailangan mong i-plot siya. Since mathematics score is on the x-axis and English score is in the y-axis. Ayan. So, in plotting, for example, so meron naman kayong plotting yan sa high school wherein, example, this is 1. So, for example, yung student 1, nakuha niya is 4 sa math, 5 sa English. So, 4 sa math, 5 sa English. So, ito si student 1. Okay. For student 2, 5 sa math, 4 sa English. So, ito yung si student 2.
For student 3, 9 sa math, 8 sa English. So, 9 sa math, 8 sa English. So, ito yung si student 3. And so on hanggang sa na-plot na natin si student number 10. And then nakita natin, so from here, nakita natin na increasing po ang kanyang data. Kahit hindi makadikit, pero nakikita natin na may increasing data. So, anong ibig sabihin yun? So, the graph indicates that there is a direct correlation between variables X and Y, which appears to be increasing. So, nalaman natin na increasing siya, so there is a direct relationship. So, ibig sabihin, sa among these 10 students, so, matalino sila sa math, at the same time, matalino din sila sa English. Parang ganun. Mahina sila sa math, mahina din sila sa English. As you can see here, tingma. Example. Ito, mouse ko yung kita. Okay. Mababa siya sa math, so mababa din siya sa English. Matalino siya sa math, hence also with the English. Ganun pa yun, ibig sabihin ng direct correlations or direct relationship. Okay. For example, kumuha din ako ng ibang 10 students. And then, I get their mathematics scores at the same time their English scores. So, ito nangyari. And then, I plotted also. Nag-plot ka din. So, nangyari din from here, eh, klarong-klaro naman, meron pa ganitong line na pwedeng gawin. That is a decreasing line. Hence, the variables are negatively correlated. Ibig sabihin, anong negatively correlated? Pag ganyan. Ibig sabihin, pag matalino ka sa English, mababa ka sa math. Or matalino ka sa math, mababa ka sa English. Yan po ang ibig sabihin ng negatively correlated. From that, malalaman natin kung ano yung interpretation ng ating data. As you can see, matalino siya sa math, mababa siya sa English. Matalino siya sa English, mababa siya sa math. Parang ganon. Okay. So, yun po ang ibig sabihin ng negatively correlated. Okay, next. So, meron na tayong direct correlation or positively correlated. Meron din tayong indirect relation or the negatively related. Ngayon, meron naman tayo ng another 10 students and we get their mathematics scores at the same time their English scores. Okay, so I plot them and I found out, so from here, i-arrange ko, eh, yung iba nandito sa labas. Hindi siya related dito. And tapos, pag mag-plot din tayo, i-raise ko muna, mag-plot din tayo ng pababa. Ayan. So, meron din tayong mga ibang portions like this one na hindi naging part o malapit sa ating line, itong line. So, anong ibig sabihin nito? So, may ibig sabihin yan. So, this means that yan pang ibig sabihin. So, this means that the cluster graph shows neither increasing nor decreasing. Hence, it represents a zero correlation. So, ibig sabihin, ang ginawa nating 10 students ay there is no relationship na pinapakita between their math scores and their English scores. Kasi hindi siya pinapakita na kumat mababa siya sa math, mababa din sa English. Hindi din pinakita na kung mababa siya sa English ay mataas siya sa math. Parang ganun. So there's no relationship sa kinuha nating data. So yun po yung tatlong pinikita ko. Direct relationship or positive correlation, indirect relationship or negative correlation, and the zero correlation. So recap tayo. Okay, nalimutan ko pala i-erase to. Okay? So, sa recap, yung positive correlated,
if the values of the two if the values of the two variables increase dito, okay, ang negative correlated erase natin. Okay, so we have positively correlated, negatively correlated, or zero. Okay, anong ibig sabihin ito? Pag positively correlated, ibig sabihin pag mataas ka sa math, eh mataas ka din sa English. Pag mababa ka sa English, pag mababa ka sa math, mababa ka din sa English. Yun po ang positively correlated. So hence, so the ibig sabihin nun, the two variables, which is your English and math. EM na lang lagay ko, erase. Yan. English and math, both increase or decrease. Ibig sabihin nun, pag mataas yung English, mataas din yung math. Pag mababa yung English, mababa din yung math. Ibig sabihin, kapwa silang parehas increasing or decreasing. While the negative correlation, ibig sabihin, one variable increase while the values of the other decrease. For example, pag mataas ka sa English, mababa ka sa math. Pag mababa ka sa English, mataas ka sa math. Yun po ang negatively correlated. But the zero correlations, walang relationship na makikita. Kasi yung ibang values ay ganito negatively, yung isa naman values of the different students ay positively. So, kaya scatter po yung kanilang plot. Okay, so we have, so tatlong correlation meron tayo. The positive, the negative, and the zero correlation. So, yun po. So, ano po yung ginamit nating plot doon? Ang tawag doon is the scatter plot. Remember, scatter plot is a convenient way of inspecting correlation between two variables. But it does not offer a measure of the strength of the correlation. Ano tong strength ng correlation? Ibig sabihin yung strength ng correlation, hindi mo alam kung kung strong ba ang kanilang positively correlated or weak lang ba? Or weak ba ang kanilang positively correlated? So, ito na yung pumapasok si Pearson product moment correlation. Asa kasi Spearman. Pero for this time, si Pearson lang muna ang i-discuss ko. Si Spearman ay i-discuss by next week kasama ang Unit 3. Okay, so ano si PPMC? So, ito yung kanyang notation ng formula. So, it is give you a numerical value to the measure of correlation. It does not only show how greatly two data sets are correlated, but also reveals if the correlation is direct or inverse, or if the data sets are correlated. Okay, so meron tayong degree of correlation. So C1 are strong positive correlation. Pag zero'ng nakuha mo, no relationship. Pag negative 1, strong negative correlation. Okay, ito yung formula. Pero it doesn't mean that you need to memorize this formula, okay? So, pinapakita ko lang sa inyo to kasi basic lang po tayo. Hindi po tayo gagamit ng SPSS to compute the Pearson product. So, SPSS is the software used in statistics. Mostly, pag nasa mathematics, you're going to get your MA or doctorate degree. So, SPSS na po ang gagamitin natin. Hindi po tayo magko-compute kasi sa dami-daming data na yan. For our activity, we will not use the SPSS, but we need to use this formula. But remember, you don't need to memorize the formula, okay? So this is the mean for the sample mean or the data set X, and Y is the sample mean for the data set Y. Okay, so what is this formula? This is the Pearson product moment correlation formula. Okay, now we go to this one. Anong kailangan nyo to, okay? Because this will be your guide for answering your activity for Unit 2. So, yung Unit 2 na activity, it can be posted by Thursday or isasama ko na lang ipopost ang Unit 2 na activity sa Unit 3. Depende kung magawa ko na yung Google Forms. Okay. So, pag yung nakuha mong R is equals to 1, ibig sabihin, sasabihin nyo kagad, there is a perfect positive correlation. Pag ang R mo is, lalagay na lang natin na, R is equal to 0.6 but less than R and less than R, wait ah, and less than 0.9. Yan. 0.9. Dito naman, 0.1 to 0.5, less than 0.6. Wait lang, erase ko muna. Yan. Yung strong negative correlation, so dito muna tayo. So this one is negative 0.1 hanggang less than 0.5. Negative pa. Well, this one is R is negative 1. Wait, paano to? Ito na lang. Wait lang ah, ano ba yung sinulat ko sa ibang section? Para parehas lang kayo. Okay. Please. Yan. Okay, so ganun ang magiging guide nyo. So please screenshot nyo yan kasi yan ang magiging guide natin. So, if your R is equals to 0, sabihin nyo little or no linear correlation. If your R is 0.1 or 0.2 hanggang 0.5, positive correlation. If your R is 0.6 hanggang 0.8, 0.7, 0.9, strong positive correlation. If your R is equals to 1, perfect positive correlation. Negative 1, strong negative correlation. And negative correlation, if your R is negative 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, hanggang 0.9. So, ito yung magiging guide natin to answer your data. Okay, saan po yung i-answer? Okay, mayroon tayong example. Okay, for your activities in Unit 2, ito yung maibibigay ko sa inyo. And then, you're going to create a table in your band paper or scratch sheets. And then, i-answer ninyo, yun ang ipipicturean ninyo, and then ipopost sa Google Classroom. I mean, i-upload sa Google Classroom. So, later on, kapag gagawin yung Google Forms for this one, sa Unit 2 na data. Okay, so paano niyang kunin? Okay, so actually, pag na-answer nyo yan, ito yung magiging answer ninyo na i-upload. Yan na, yung kompletong detalye. Okay, baka tanungin ninyo kung saan kinuha.
Okay, yung summation, so summation, you just add all of them. Yan. I-add mo, yan po yung summation. Add mo, yan. And so with this one, summation, just add, add, add. Okay. After adding, since kailangan natin si mean, so I forgot to put here mean, mean din ito. And so with this one. So you just get the mean. So what will be your mean? So mean natin for the x, so ilalagay natin mean for the x is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 students daw yan. Okay, so you got 48. So 48 divided by 10. So your mean is 4.8, 4x. While for your y, 50. 50 yung kanyang total, ah. Divide by 10. So, 5. Okay. Next. Paano naman to? Paano to nakuha? Yan. I mean, dito. Ito lahat. Tinan mo yung formula. Xi minus the mean. Ano yung xi? Ito yung xi. Since dito siya nagpo-fall, ito po yung xi niya. Yan. So, your xi is 4. Minus the mean, 4.8. So, gives you negative 0.8. So, with this one, 5 minus 4.8 give us 0.2. Next, 9 minus 4.8 give us 4.2. 2 minus 4.8 give us negative 2.8. And so on and so forth hanggang sa dulo. Ganun lang po. Kunin yung xi dito minus the mean. How about ito? Same lang din. Kunin yung yi, which is 5, minus the mean, which is 5, equals 0. 4 minus 5 equals negative 1. 8 minus 5 give us 3. 3 minus 5 give us negative 2. And so on hanggang sa baba. Okay. How about this one? It's just the square of this one. Diba? Yan. So, ibig sabihin, square mo lang yung answer nito. So, negative 0.8 square or negative 0.8 times negative 0.8 give us 0.64. Same with the other. So 0.2 square is 0.04. 4.2 times 4.2 is 17.64. Negative 2.8 times negative 2.8 is 7.84, and so on. How about this one? Just square, getting the square of that. Okay. Paano yan? 0 squared or 0 times 0 is 0. Negative 1 times negative 1 is 1. 3 times 3 is 9. Negative 2 times negative 2 is 4. And so on. How about this one? Wait lang. Nawawala yung mouse. Yung mouse ko nawawala. Okay, yan. Tinan nyo. Ito, which is this one. And this one, which is also this one. Yan. Ibig sabihin, this one, and this one, i-multiply. So, negative 0.8 times 0 is 0. Ano pa? 0.2 times 0 is point, negative 1 pala. Wait lang, ah. Dapat gumamit talaga tayo ng ruler dito kasi baka katulad dito, akala ko 0, negative 1 pala. Next, 4.2 times
3 equals 12.6. Next, negative 2.8 times negative 2 is 5.6, and so on. So, ganun po yung pagka-answer ninyo, ah. So, you need to show this one. Ito, yung ginawa ko. Before nyo na-arrive yung si 0. So, you need to show me how did you come up with negative 0.8. So, 4 equals 4 minus 4.8 equals 0.8. Ganyan. Tapos, yung dito sa summation, di nyo na kailangan i-show pa yung add. Automatic naman ako na mag-add dyan para makita kung ano yung answer. Okay, so that is how you're going to do with your activities in unit 2. So, after you do this activity, yun na yun. Gagamitin nyo na si the formula ni Pearson. Ano yung formula? Ito. Yan. So, ano yung sa taas? This one is the summation of the product. So, ito yun. Ito. So, yung answer mo dito, lalagay natin sa dito. Ayan. Next, ano yung sa baba? We have the radicals or the square root. So, ano to? Xi minus mean squared. Ano yan? Xi minus... Yan. Yan. Lalagay natin dito. And then, this one, kunin natin dito. Yan. So, lalagay natin dito. Yan po. And then, get the sum of this 65.6 times 60. We have this one. Then, get the square root. Use only 5 decimal places. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, 62.73755. So, 58 divided by 62.73755. We have 0.92. So, anong 0.92? The computed cost. So, ito yung sasabihin natin sa at the end of the sa baba ng formula nyo. May blank line doon, ilalagay nyo lang. Sabihin nyo, pwede din hindi na kasama to. Sasabihin nyo diretso, strong positive correlation. So, saan kinuha si strong positive correlation? So, meron tayong 0.92. Ano yung sinabi ko sa inyo last time? Screenshot ito. So, 0.92. So, nandito siya dito. So, meron siyang strong positive correlation. Sa letter B siya. So, yun ang ilalagay natin dito. There is a strong positive correlation. Okay, question. Question. So, yung si Spearman, discuss ko yan by next meeting na. So, yung activity, so, just watch for the activity kung isasama ko na ba yung activity nito sa Thursday. Okay, so question tayo. May question ba? I guess there's no question. So, please open your camera because I'm going to get the documentations. O, sana yung mga iba? Tutulog na ba yung iba dyan? Okay, so picture muna tayo. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so you may close now. Okay, so yung score ninyo sa midterm and the three quizzes will be given by next week. Popost ko lang sa GC yung mga list ng pangalan na hindi pa nakakuha ng midterm and the three quizzes. And the scores will be given to you by PM, private message po sa ating group, sa inyong messenger. Okay, so if there's no question regarding the activities and lectures, so see you on next Tuesday, which is December 1. Yay, December na tayo. So, lapit ng Christmas, December na. Okay, so for the activities, Thursday yun ipopost. Tingnan nyo lang sa Google Classroom. So, if no more questions, so thank you for your time. God bless. See you on next Tuesday. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Ay, yung